Oh, hey, you guys. It's Jana here with this week's Dashboard by Monolith. Last week, we were heavy on the tech deets, updating you on some of the biggest hard drives to date and product releases. Before I get started, take 5 minutes to get yourself set for this episode by clicking on this link here. This week, we're diving into Tiger Lake, updating you on new gear and some mind-blowing news that will really stick in your brain. So let's fire up the dashboard. Meow. It's here. During a live stream session last week, Asus announced their 11th gen Tiger Lake platform with 9 new chips from 7 to 15 watts, with supposedly higher boost speeds than the previous generation.
Oh, just got it.
If they weren't competitors before, then they are now, as this chipset pitches them directly across the ring from the Ryzen 4000 Renoir series. With Intel's Iris Xe graphics engine, the Tiger Lake chips are estimated to have a better performance than AMD equivalents. These are some pretty ballsy statements from a manufacturer that is struggling to get their other piggies to market. Tiger Lake chips cover all 3 of the core families, 3, 5, and 7, and Intel has segmented the new chips into UP3 and UP4 to support OEMs with proper laptop production. If there isn't the right cooling present, the performance just won't be there, which sounds kind of like me, to be honest. If I overheat, I'm out. They used the new 10nm SuperFin, which is a rework of their initial 10nm node, who was a bit of a problem child. The changes seem to be working as the performance is matching the results of other denser process nodes on the market. When paired with the Willow Cove cores, the new nodes have a frequency improvement of 20%. How long they can keep it up totally depends on the power and thermal allocations for this pair. Time will tell. I love getting all super Yoda with these flat facts, like tell, time will. It's just awkward when it doesn't need to be. Acer seems to be one of the first on board for Intel's new gear. They're launching the Swift 5 with the 11th gen cores this November. Acer also released 2 different versions of the Swift 3 with different screen ratios for those looking for a lower price point. Both Swift 3 versions will feature Iris Xe graphics, Thunderbolt 4, and Wi-Fi 6. The Swift 5 will have a slick magnesium, lithium, and aluminum frame with an ergonomically angled keyboard. The rest of the specs are fairly lean at this point, so we look forward to seeing how they work for gaming and what their battery life is like. Also, anyone notice the Intel emblem looks a wee bit different after a decade or two? Weird. It's probably nothing. By the time the Swifts are out, you know what else might be?
What's that?
Your Apple Watch Series 6?
Yes.
Legit leakers have suggested this watch won't be available in September with the iPhone 12. Full specs may be revealed this month, but the product might not get to market until October. This could be a blessing in disguise, as many suggest this delay is due to patent-pending technology, including Touch ID, gesture tracking, and possibly new biometric features. So far, we only know from the patent company that Apple is playing with these features. The when, where, how, and what is still up in the air.
So stay tuned.
Yes, that's my line. In their summit last week, MSI announced they're refreshing their existing modern and prestige lines with Tiger Lake chips and releasing a new business line with Intel's 11th gen CPUs. They're shifting away from their NVIDIA partnership and relying solely on Intel's Xe graphics, which is bold. For consumers, this may be an indicator that these Intel cards will live up to the hype. The Summit series is split into E and B, both have 14 and 15 inch variants, plus a 13 inch convertible drop top in the E series. The E series is more integrated and has IR webcams and touchscreens, but otherwise their key features are the same and include TPM, Intel vPro, fingerprint sensor, 11th gen Intel CPUs, Thunderbolt 4, Wi-Fi 6, etc., etc. Honestly, I love my MSI. It's my work beast. So check out their new line on our website, monolithgroup.ca. Samsung is being a bit coy with their product releases lately. For just long enough for us to notice that it was retracted, Samsung released specs on their 980 Pro SSD. They've been dangling this carrot since CES this year, and it's their first consumer SSD to support PCIe 4.0. But we don't have more technical information or release date yet. The 980 will be Samsung's first Pro model to use TLC NAND instead of MLC, a product they've been holding onto way too long. Like way too long. This switch will reduce the write endurance of the 980 Pro to half that of the 970 Pro and other TLC-based products, but it should be more affordable against other high-end consumer NVMe SSDs. This teaser makes us curious about what the 980 Evo will look like. Will Samsung launch itself into QLC territory?
Oh, calm down, Turbo.
I know, baby steps, right? We can confirm a pretty large and in charge reveal by Team Group. The QX is their new consumer-grade SSD that can store up to 15.3 terabytes of data and can fit into a typical laptop, which obviously drives with this capacity generally cannot do and is better suited to workstations anyways. But what the heck? If you need the space and have $4,000, then why not? Like their other products, the QX SSD has SATA 6GB interface, and Team Group claims it has up to 560 megs per second sequential read speed and up to 480 megs per second write speed when the pseudo SLC cache is enabled. Apparently, they use 3D QLC NAND memory, but they say nothing about what controller is being used. But we do know that it supports SLC caching with a DRAM cache buffer. As in many things, you get what you pay for, so I guess Team Group's made-to-order QX 15.3 is no exception. So I'm a pretty trustworthy person, but some rumors are too good to keep to myself. We already know from earlier this year that HP is shipping out its Reverb G2 headset this fall, but word on the web is that there's an Omni Concept version that will include face, eye, and mouth tracking. The blog Aggiornamenti Lumina, is it Italian? They posted a rumor that with an appendage that showed that there could be a camera for mouth tracking and an embedded electrode in the face pad. HP killed our curiosity, refusing to comment on speculation. Okay, fine. We'll just be here waiting. Vegans beware. We have some superhuman news.
Superhuman?
Exactly. According to the US FDA, Neuralink reached breakthrough status with their limb tracking after conducting brain interface testing on pigs. Using their prototype devices, researchers achieved rudimentary limb tracking capabilities based on brain activity.
Who cares?
Like, okay, so what's going on here? Neuralink is the brainchild of Mr. Musk. Sorry, I had to. The point of these products is to invent an implantable device detecting and deciphering electrical signals from the brain, as well as communicating by writing to the human brain with the use of its own electrical signals. The initial intent is that Neuralink would be used to solve brain-related medical conditions such as memory loss, hearing loss, blindness, paralysis, seizures, addiction, strokes, brain damage, and mental health challenges. It's a mouthful, it's a lot. In the long run, the company is seeing its profitability in gaming as well. Some business and some pleasure, as always with Mr. Musk. Let's run through some basics. Similarly, like you've probably seen in a few sci-fi films, the Neuralink 0.9, new and improved with no wires, I can't believe I'm saying this. It will be inserted into the brain with a coin-sized incision and is inductively charged through the skin. The algorithm for the limb prediction and tracking did show significant error initially, but remember, there's little to no precedent on what the margin should look like. Eventually, the company wants the unit to be so precise that it can enable, and I quote, a quadriplegic to accurately play StarCraft. That is aspirational. And this may take a generation, but hey, by then we might be living on Mars, so really, why not? Back here on Earth, you guys only have a few more days to get in on our Code Red giveaway. The prize is an all-apps package of Adobe Creative Cloud for one full year for all you creators out there. Never miss an episode of Dashboard by liking this video and subscribing to our channel. You know the deal. Find us on social and on our website, monolithgroup.ca. I'm Jana, this is Dashboard, and I'll see you next week. The when, where, how, and what is still up in the air.
Yeah,
so
yeah, we know. Stay tuned for updates.
Yes. Can I go home now?